Hi, my name is Manny Alikani. I am the Dean and Professor at CTOR Academy, and I'd like to welcome you to CTOR channel. The topic of today's discussion is couple. What happens if we apply two forces equal in magnitude, parallel line of action, but in the opposite direction to a tooth? Let's look at the example. Assume that we apply a force F1 that is 5 millimeters away from the center of resistance, and we apply the opposite force F2 that is 5 millimeters also away from the center of resistance, but is applied in the opposite direction and parallel to the force 1. What would happen to the tooth? If you remember from the previous discussion, equivalence system, to see what happens to the tooth, we just move the force to the center of resistance, and also we draw the moment that that force produces. F1 and F2 apply 50 centinewtons in opposite direction to the center of resistance. Therefore, they cancel each other. How about the moment? F1 is applied with the 5 millimeter distance from the center of resistance. If you remember from the moment discussion, the magnitude of the moment would be equal to the magnitude of F1, that is 50 centinewton, times the distance, that is 5 millimeters, therefore 250 centinewton millimeter. This moment is applied counterclockwise. Let's calculate the magnitude of the moment for the F2. Again, F2 is 50 centinewton, applied 5 millimeter from the center of resistance. Therefore, the moment that it produces is 250 centinewton millimeter, and it is also counterclockwise. So when we apply two force in this condition, we produce a bigger moment. The moment would be a total of M1, that is related to the F1 force, and M2, that is related to F2 force. So the total moments would be 500 centinewton millimeter. So this is a very unique situation. Couple is two forces that are opposite to each other with the parallel line of action and equal magnitude, that when we apply it to a tooth would not cause any displacement, would not move the center of resistance from one place to another. It just produces a large moment, and the moment, as we discussed before, can produce rotation. Let's look at some of the characteristics of the couple. The first characteristic of the couple is that the magnitude of the moment that is produced by couple is equal to the one force times the distance between the two couples. Let's see if this is correct. Assume we are applying a force of 50 centinewton 7 millimeters away from the center of resistance. The other force is 50 centinewton, 3 millimeters away from center of resistance. In the first examples that we started our discussion today, we applied the forces equal distance. Now we apply the forces with a different distance. How much would be the magnitude of the total moment? Again, you calculate F1, that is 50 centinewton, times 7 millimeters, that should be 350 centinewton millimeters, F2, that is 50 centinewton, times the distance, that is 3 millimeters, and that's 150 centinewton millimeters. As we discussed, the total moment that appears in the system is the collection or addition of these two small moments, M1 and M2. That together will become 500 centinewton millimeters. Now, let's look at some interesting rules that we can find here. 3 millimeters and 7 millimeters together are 10 millimeters. So if we just multiply one of the forces, doesn't matter, F1, that would be 50 times the distance between the two forces of the couple, 500 centinewton, or we multiply F2, that is 50 centinewton, times the distance between two forces, that is 10 millimeters, the both give us the total moments of the couple that is produced in the system. So the first principles of the couples is the magnitude of the moment that appear in the system is equal to the magnitude of one force times the distance between the two forces. Rule number two, if you want to change the direction of the moment, just change the direction of your couple. So in the left side of the string, application of the couple produce a counterclockwise moment. In the right side of the screen, if we just change the direction of the forces, application of couple will produce a clockwise rotation. So by changing the sense of the forces, we can produce opposite direction moments. The third principles of the couple is that is the location of the application of the couple is important in moments that they're producing. Let's look at a different example. What happens if I apply a force 50 centinewton, 15 millimeters from the center of resistance, in one side of the center of resistance? On the other hand, I apply a 50 centinewton force 5 millimeters from the center of resistance, but both forces are in one side of the center of resistance. Well, one force, the F1, will produce a counterclockwise moment, while the force 2 produce a clockwise moment. So these two moments will, if you want to add them together, they actually deduct from each other. The total of the moment in the system is 500 centinewton millimeter. Assume we apply the same moments both sides of the center of resistance. The total moment in your system is still is 500 centinewton millimeter. It seems doesn't matter where you apply the couple. The point of application of the couple is not important. As long as the forces stays the same in the couple, and as long as the distance between the forces stays the same, the magnitude of the moment in the system stays the same. That also has significant clinical application, because many times we cannot apply our couple in the place that we like. That gives us the freedom to apply the couple in any place and achieve the same result. The other aspect of the couple that is important is that we can move the forces, align the line of action, and have the same effect. Let's look at an example. Assume we are applying a F1 and F2 to a tooth. Both forces are both sides of the tooth. What happens if I move the F2 around the line of action? So F1 and F2 both would be in the same side of the tooth. Do I still have a couple? Yes. So movement of the forces along the line of action does not change the result of your couple. You will produce the same moment. Another principles of the couple is the rotation of the couple in the space. Not all the times we can apply the couple in the surfaces that we like. Is that going to affect our result? No, not necessarily. As long as you keep the distance between the forces the same and the forces are the same, you can rotate the couple in the space, of course in the same dimension, and you have the same effect. It's important. Same dimension. If you change your dimension, you are producing a moment in another space, another dimension of a space. So that should not be mixed with this. So let's look at the example. We apply F1 and F2 with a distance of D1, and that produces a counterclockwise rotation. Application of same force with the same distance, if you rotate it in the space, produce M2, and M1 and M2 are equal because the forces and the distance are equal. The last principles that I want to talk about is the relationship between the force and the distance. Sometimes it is not possible to maintain the distance between the forces the same. Therefore, if we want to produce the same moment, we can compensate by increasing the magnitude of the force. So for example, in the left side of the screen, application of a couple F1 and F2 produce a moment M1 that is counterclockwise. The distance is D1. What happens if I rotate them couple in the space, but now the distance D2 is half of the distance D1. In this condition, to make sure that I'm producing the same amount of moments, we will increase the force twice more, and the result would be the same. Thank you for listening to another session of Mechanotherapy by CTOR channel. The topic of the next session would be part 2 of the couple. If you are interested, keep watching. Thank you.